Time for more grades. The last one was pretty easy. I mean, just the picture was already showing the grid for us, and Instagram did the work for us. So time to be more subtle with another kind of grid, another kind of grid. Heading to the profile area, let's put some more grid. So the basic grid, okay. The first row is particular because there is four equal columns in it. So that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. But then we have other rows. We have 3 more. All full of text and sometimes buttons, but still rows. And voila. We just have to customize it a bit and it will be already ready. So first thing, let's set the grid 8 to auto. Then I'm going to put just a small avatar in it. The avatar will be in the first row, the first column. Then a picture inside. Actually, we're just going to duplicate the picture already present in our page. In the content, the tabs, and I guess it's the last tabs. I can already duplicate the avatar item. Control C and just put right here. This one, yes. Control V as a child and a Control S to save. Okay. The other one is just text. It's text item. Let's even put something cool, which is skeleton text. So what is skeleton text? Gonna appear any moment now. Just a bit loading-like text. So it's doing a cool effect. We still don't have text, but this one is pretty cool, I think. So it can imagine that we'll make relevant text here, just like in our example. Okay, so that's it for the first bar. The second one is pretty easy. It's just a title with a description. So the item object is perfect for that, a generic item. Just going to put an item and then put some header in it for the title. It's more like a heading. Pardon my English. Okay. So we put the heading and then for the text, a regular paragraph. Okay, all right. The next grid is, I believe, a button. Just a regular button. The next row. Okay. And what is the last one? Let's say title and paragraph 2. So we can just copy our item and paste it. As a child, Control S, so we can save everything we have. And that's it, we're done. We just have then to put some text here. Should have put it right before copy pasting, but you know, life issue. And it will be some effects, some text. All right, just our button is not quite beautiful. So let's just put some text in it. And that will do the stuff. Finally, if you're not a big fan of the item layout, we can just put a good old regular div block to replace it and just put inside our heading and paragraph and deleting the item. I guess that's a matter of taste, but that is the subject of the next video. We'll dig more into the div block. So let's stay tuned.